Hey everybody, welcome back. Falcon, Timber, and Stone. Let's get the game going on over here. So, I am recording today on... There is a merchant on the way, if I'm right, from the last episode. I'm pretty sure he's coming down this way right now, which is why we have a trader over here, which is... who is this? Davion Evans with his sweet cloak. Cloak always gets me. And here comes the merchant right over here. You see him? I see him. And if you don't see him, check this out. Let me pause the game really quickly. What did you do, Falcon? Well, thanks to your comments, you guys have been telling me that if I hit the page down key, which didn't really work for me, like, I actually tried this off camera, like, people were like, Falcon, if you press the page down key, you'll be able to see the depths of the level, and you'll be able to tell where there's enemies and people a lot easier. And that wasn't working for me, but I remember that I actually removed my key bindings, the default ones, to kind of something that worked to my, I guess my experience a bit better, so it's just literally the down arrow key for me. But yeah, I saw this, and I was like, holy shit. So this will let me actually see everything on the map, which is actually pretty good because I'll be able to spot enemies a lot easier now too. So I'm actually pretty excited about that, so thank you for that comment. I am now recording on... What am I recording on right now? This is going to be Tuesday, February 10. So this will probably show up, I believe I still have like probably 3 more videos to release with Timber and Stone, which means it'll be Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So this video will show up on Saturday, so just keep that in mind. I always try to make this known because people will leave me comments over a few episodes and they'll be like, Falcon, I told you to do this, I told you to do that. It's like, I understand, I'm trying to do it. The thing is that I haven't done it because, you know, I record episodes in small little batches whenever I get free time because, you know, this is kind of like a hobby for me. I just do this whenever I have free time. So whenever I do have free time, I have to take advantage of it and record as many episodes as possible because, it'll allow me to kind of release videos daily as opposed to, like, you know, one video every 3 or 4 days or something like that. So, I just wanted to kind of get that out of the way. But we do have this trader coming in, which I'm kind of excited about. I'm also excited about this whole depth thing that you guys told me about, so appreciate that very much. Now, the other thing I wanted to do before this trader even gets here is, the other thing is people telling me, Falcon, make your quarry a bit bigger. And number two, you shouldn't probably even make it inside because if you're going to be expanding your village from over here, you might want it somewhere else, and I do agree with that, but I'm kind of in here as it is, so what I'm even considering doing is maybe even making an underground village, if that's even possible. I'd imagine it would be. It would probably take some creative juices on my side to pull it off, but we'll cross that bridge once we get there. But what I'm wanting to do right now is, since we do know, or since I now know about this whole depth thing, it might make it easier for me to mine. So what if I did this, right? Oh, hey, don't go anywhere, Key, or fucking arrow mouse, stop it. Let me go depth down over here. Now, we're down over here right now, correct? Totally are. Let's do this about... Let's see. There's quite a few levels down before we hit the bottom, right? Let me zoom in here a little bit. And what I would like to do is go into mining. And I want to mine from here to the top side and kind of make this a bit bigger if I can, which is, you know, something that I've always told my girlfriend I never really actually have succeeded with. But that's besides the point. We're not even talking about that right now. Let's keep our head in the game here, literally and figuratively. What if we mine from down here upwards, right? So let's do, I don't know, we'll do something like you over here. Nope, you're supposed to just stay as a 2x1 type of thing. Let me go up now, all right? So we'll do this. This is what I want to do over here. And then I want to mine all this out and make this even a bigger mining project than it already is. But what this will do, it'll probably give me a better chance to find some more ore, which is something we're kind of really desperate in need of right now. Well, actually not really desperate in need of anymore, but the more ore we have, the better, because my blacksmith can continue doing some fancy work over here. So let's go up through here. There you go. That seems pretty good to me. Let's get the game going on over here. Now, this will be quite a bit of a project, so I'm going to leave them alone for a while. Now, cancel that, please, if you don't mind. Mining, stop, go away. All right, here comes the Merchant Man. Now, with Merchant Man, let's see what we have over here that I'm willing to do away with. Seeds sell for a good price, so if we want to get some new coins, or not new coins, but if we want to get coins, we need to sell some of these seeds off. So that's already set up for selling. So is the carrot seeds, and what about the wheat seeds? They totally are, too. Now, in terms of raw materials, I'm always down to sell some extra dirt and some raw stone if he's looking to buy it. Raw wood as well, we could, you know, probably get some more wood. Actually, you know what, wood? Let's not sell any more wood off. Because the other tip that I've been reading about is, I've been getting rid of the stumps, and people have been really mad about this. Like, Falcon, if you want your trees to grow back, don't remove the stumps. So, stumps are going to no longer be removed. Believe me, I assure you they're not going to happen anymore. We do have weed, but that's just, oh yeah, I also learned a little bit more about the herders, which I will talk about soon. This I did on my own volition, though. I kind of had to go to the forums and look up how the herding actually worked. So I will discuss that pretty soon. Everything else over here, I think we're okay with. Tin ore, yeah, you could sell some of that if you want. Maybe the Price is Right will kind of do it. And by the Price is Right, I'm not talking about the CBS show with, you know... I was going to say Alex Trebek? That's Jeopardy. Well, I guess the Price is Right is now run by Drew Carey, right? Is it still run by Drew Carey? I don't even know. Either way, he's willing to buy 41 animal fur for one coin. No. Fuck yourself. One coin, really? Dog, for 41 fur coats? You gotta be out of your goddamn mind. Alrighty, so we have somebody going to sleep over here. It's one of my miners. He's willing to buy 8 wool for one coin. How many wolves do we have? We have 16 in stockpile. Yeah, sure. Okay, I'll do 8 wool for one coin. It's a little bit better than fucking 41, that much is for certain. Now, do you have anything that I want to buy, though? I mean, I have some stuff set up for selling or for buying. It's just a matter of you actually offering it to me, dog. The merchant is willing to buy 10 pumpkin seeds for 20 coin. Now, that's good. We have 18. If I sell 10, we'll be left with 8. 20 coin, I accept that. Now, the reason why I want to get some coin is because I've heard mixed reactions or mixed opinions about how you get more people to join. Oh no, a goblin mortar has been spotted by dragon. Oh no, that's a goblin. Okay, where is dragon at? Number one. Okay, you're over here. Where is this? Uh-oh. No, that's not a goblin mortar. That's our boy Fatal Extraction, right? Where's this goblin at? Oh, he's right here. Oh shit. Oh my, you don't even look like a goblin, really. You look like a fucking rat dude. Oh my lord, you look like an ugly, angry rat dude. Alrighty, here's what we do. You need to run, dragon. Dragon, it's time for you to... Do you have any... Oh my lord, if he's chopping down wood, he might not... Oh no, he's really encumbered. That's no good. Hey, can we have you just drop whatever you're carrying right now? Because you're not going to be able to make it back in time. That guy's going to jack you up. That doesn't work. Maintain an inventory. That's not gonna work either. Hey, I would love to just drop this right now if I could, but I don't think I can. Okay, this is gonna be a problem because Fatal Extraction is one of my fighters, right? Oh, shit, man. I thought we were gonna start off on a good note here, but no, we already have a Goblin Mortar coming up at us over here. Okay. Fatal Extraction, you are Infantry 4. Silent Psychopath's my other infantry, and then we also have Scabia over here. Okay, so Fatal Extraction, you need to, number one, go infantry, and you need to go get some weapons, dog. You really have to. Hey, what are you doing here, Unitless? Go away. Stop. So, you need to go and maintain some inventory really quickly here. So, yeah, you have to go drop all that off. I hope you can walk kind of fast over here. I hope so. Let's do... We have a hard chest now. So, we'll do Light Helm for him. He'll do a shield as well. He'll do light chest, he'll do light boots, and he will do sword. That's his setup. Now, Silent Psychopath is going to be using the heavy chest, so we'll keep that in mind. So, Silent Psychopath, where are you at? You are over here. Good. At least you're nearby the carriage with some weapons here. So, we'll have you go into maintain inventory. We'll do light helm, shield, heavy chest, and light boots, and then we'll give you a sword as well. I believe that's all the weapons I do have for these guys. I'm not gonna get my archer set up because we're kind of running low on arrows as it is. So there is that. Now, you, my friend, need to speed it up here, and I don't think you're gonna be able to make it. You're encumbered, like severely. So you need to come this way. Oh, he's coming right after him. Oh, I'm so fucked with him. I am super fucked with him. Look, merchant, this isn't the time. Dragon's about to go down. He's willing to sell one corn seed for 20 coin. Yes, I would like some corn. We don't have that. Oh, my lord. Goblin, please leave me alone. Don't be such an asshole, okay? Fatal Extraction, you need to come over here. Oh, my lord. Dragon, I don't know what to tell you, dog. I'm sorry, you're in a tough spot. A merchant is willing to sell 8 copper ore for 4 coin. That's not too bad, to be honest with you. But now that I'm going to expand my... I guess, mining situation, I don't think we need it anymore, so I'm going to decline that one, too. What I can't decline is this guy over here that's about to destroy Dragon. Oh, my lord. 20 damage. Dragon, you need to turn around and hit this guy. Dragon is so dead. Oh, 6 damage? That's not gonna do it. 9? Wait a minute. Dragon, come back. Dragon, do a comeback. We've stunned him. That goblin's stunned. He has no idea what's happening. Dragon is a base god. Dragon is a fucking base. Look at this guy walk away with all this swag. Like, you know, haters gonna hate. Look at this guy. Look what he just did to him. Let me gather the resources over here if we can. Wow. Oh my god. Okay, that was terrifying. I'll tell you that much right now. I thought it was a goner. I'm not sure what happened. He hit him with fucking bash and he stunned him or something. He hit him with like, stun powder or something. I'm not sure. I'm over here going to Pokemon attacks and stuff suddenly. But we did it. We somehow got him out of the way. Merchant, yeah, you could go fuck yourself. You probably brought that Mortar along with you. He's your backup or something. Let me lower this down here a bit. Oh my lord. Oh, what are you supposed to be? Oh, that's a goblin archer. That's a goblin archer. Okay, Dragon, you're out of the woods yet. This guy's gonna be upset that you killed his friend. Are there any more goblins around here? This is becoming a little bit heralding. Oh shit, what are you supposed to be? Oh, that's another goblin archer. Okay. Goblin archers scare me because they're gonna definitely have to drop on my melee units now. What are you over here? You're another goblin. Oh my lord, you have like 2 axes or something. You're red. This guy's red. Okay. Oh, it's scary. Okay. Are you guys like suited for battle already? Like, I'm gonna need you out here regardless of which now. Now, where is, well, let me look at my unit list here. We're looking for Fatal Extraction, who is down over here. Are you gonna come over here and grab your equipment? You better be. Yes, he's coming down here to do that. Silent Psychopath, you need to hit the road really, really fast, wherever you might be at. So Silent Psychopath's gonna be, hey. Am I an idiot? I forgot to switch your class, didn't I? You're equipped, you just have to switch your class over. Okay, so we'll do infantry. Okay. Goblin archers over here. We're still not in trouble. As long as Dragon could just avoid what's happening over here, you'll probably do away with this. So, oh shit, here he comes. This goblin mortar is actually attacking this woodchop pile. You know what? That might actually give me some time to make it back safe over here with Dragon. Merchant, do you want to, you know, deal with that goblin mortar for me? You can. By all means, go right on ahead. Oh, he's shooting arrows. Oh, he missed that one. Yeah, he's definitely going after my wood stockpile. That's okay. Dragon, come down over here. Oh my lord, you're so fast. Is there a way, like, if there is a way, by the way, guys, if you know how to, like, just drop whatever's in your inventory to go fast, let me know. I don't know about that. At least I don't see him, unless... No, don't stop him. Don't stop him. That's wrong. Independently chop nearest tree, tool breakage, show notification. I wish there was like a way to drop stuff, but I don't think there is. Yeah, keep walking, dog. Okay. You're equipped now, which is good. Where is your friend? Fatal Extraction, this is not time to sleep right now, dude. This is definitely not the time to sleep. I know you might be tired. You're actually pretty tired, but this is not the time. So what we're going to do is Silent Psychopath, you come outside. Right now. Alrighty. There's some arrows just flying by randomly because this guy keeps missing. Remember that time you were just walking by and a fucking arrow just hit you out of nowhere? It's kind of like, oh, where'd that arrow come from? Oh, that woodpile is on fire. I do like the fact that because he's shooting the woodpile, it actually catches fire. Oh, hey, Dragon, don't even worry about that woodpile. You come over here, dog. You don't even worry about what's happening over there. That woodpile could burn for all I care. All right, you're outside. Good. Now, let's lower the depth here one more time, and let's see where our enemies are at. We knew there's red dudes over here. Red Man. You might know him from Wu-Tang Clan. Now, if we could only find his Method Man, we'll be okay. So Red Man's over here. Method Man is... at least this guy's pretty far off. He's actually hanging out all the way over here by himself, so that's okay. He won't be a problem for now. I think we have to go after dude setting shit on fire, and then we go after maybe that guy, and finally we'll do Red Man. Alrighty, so let me move the depth back up, and you come up here, or keep walking where you're going. Silent Psychopath, you and, I'm sorry, Fatal Extraction, you have to wake your ass up. No time to sleep right now. Alrighty, so you start making your way up to here, Fatal Extraction. You are equipped properly, correct? Wait a minute, hey! Dude, come on. I told you to go equip yourself. Look what you're doing over here. You're wasting my hard-earned time. It's not really hard-earned. But still, you're wasting my time. Oh, wow. Those arrows actually are on fire. That's the reason how he set it on fire. I thought he was just using regular arrows, and I was like, hey, how does that work? But now that makes sense to me. Alright, you come over here, equip yourself really fast. Alrighty. So, Silent Psychopath, this might be terrifying because this guy has range, but we have to go for it. Can't have him destroy all my shit over here. Are you equipping yourself now? It looks like you are. Fatal Extraction, are you good now? You have a Gladius, you're properly equipped. Okay. Let's come outside, my friend. Now you are going to come and fight him. Alright, as long as he's over here busy with that wood stockpile, it's okay. Dragon, I need you to be really careful about where you're walking and avoiding these arrows over here. Alright, did you spot him yet? You don't spot him yet, okay. But that's okay, he's over here busy burning this shit down, so maybe he might not even notice you. And that's okay. What are the chances this motherfucker's gonna do much damage against me anyway? Alright, we spotted him now, finally. Well, yeah. I'd imagine that the wood stockpile on fire would have been a pretty good example as to where he might be at. Alright, there you go. Go after him. Go after him. 31. Oh, he can't even do any damage. 2 hits and he's done. Alrighty. You need to continue going down this way, if you don't mind. And we have 2 more still about us. Let me lower the depth one more time over here. Just to make sure we know what's happening. If you guys hear any background noise, by the way, there is some construction happening in the back. So I do apologize for that, but there's really not much I can do about it right now because, you know, people do their own thing. You're just making a fire. You're not lighting shit on fire, are you? That's just your own fire? It is, okay. You better not be calling for reinforcements, you piece of shit. I'm not entirely sure how the goblins work. This is my first time ever meeting them. We have another dude over there, though. Okay. So, what I want to do is, since we're done with this guy, you come over. Well, I guess we could gather the resources here. But, what I want to do is you are going to come and meet our friend over here. Oh my lord. So scary. That is so terrifying. Now you need to come over here and drop off this lumber and then just avoid the woods here for a while. Fatal Extraction, I'm going to send you on a solo journey against Redman. How is that going to be? How's that going to work out for me? I'm not entirely sure, but I have faith in you, my friend. Although, wait a minute. No, we should wait. We should wait because that guy did have 2 weird axe blades on him, so it might not be as simple as just dealing with an archer. So, let me zoom out here a little bit. Our depth's still a little bit fucked, but that's okay. Fatal Extraction, I don't need you to go to sleep right now. I just need you to hang out here for a bit. He wants to go to sleep. He definitely wants to go to sleep. Let's do military, right? Is what we're looking for. Maybe set up a guard position over here. So we'll set up a guard position, at least for now. Up here. Preferably. Right here. So cancel out. And I want you to go to that guard position if you can. And just hang out there for a while. I know you're tired. We'll get you some rest really soon. And let's go and have you stay idle, combat training, operate siege weapons, one standard guard position. Perfect. You're already set up for it. So you, over here. Alrighty. I'll come back to you really soon. Silent Psychopath, where are you at? Oh, she's right here. I see her. Where is Goblin Man at? Goblin Man's way over the way over there now. So, knowing that, let's send her over here. Alright, and Fatal Extraction, no bullshitting around. Look, he's leaving back. He wants to go get some rest. You know what I could do? Assuming this guy causing the fire over here doesn't really do too much damage, I could just leave him alone. I just hope he doesn't call his friends. That's what he's doing. And I'll let Fatal Extraction get some sleep, and then afterwards, he'll probably hopefully be ready to fight. That is my goal right now. Alright, so Silent Psychopath, you keep doing your thing. Now, he might get a few shots off on you because he is going to probably spot you. He's not busy over here lighting shit on fire, so he might spot you. But that's okay. At least the first time that we dealt with him, the other guy didn't really cause any damage to you. Then again, you do have the strong armor, so that might be playing some part into this. So here we go. Go after him. Up, oh, 1. Oh, 19 damage. Okay, never mind. That guy did cause some damage to you. You know, it's not too bad. Could have been worse. Now, gather resources. Alrighty. We're not done yet. So now that you're done over here, I think as long as Fatal is Fatal going back, he's probably going back. He's already there, as a matter of fact. Okay. It's been kind of a stressful start to an episode. It's my first recording of the day, and I'm already dealing with, like, goblins over here. I wanted to have a good start of recording, you know, just get some work done. But no, that wasn't going to happen. Now, I'm worried about Homeboy over here, but I feel like the faster we get rid of him, probably the better for us. So let's have you just walk over there if you can. Are you walking that way? It seems like you might be. Let's have you come this way. Fatal Extraction, it's time to wake your ass up again. Unless, you know what, is there another person that could do what Fatal can do for us? I would just unequip him. Yeah, infantry. We could get Scabia, who's over here building away right now. Scabia, what are you doing? You're just getting shit over here ready? Alright, you know what? Fatal, do me a solid here. So you could kind of rest, and at the same time, if we could get Scabia leveled up to an infantry, it might not be the worst thing for us. So, Fatal, you're going to have to just drop your items really quickly right now. Let's see here. We're going to go with maintain inventory, 0, 0, 0 right through. And Fatal Extraction, wake your ass up one more time. Come over here and drop your stuff off. And you're going to just go back to being a forager more than likely. So we'll have you forage. Okay, Scabia, before you leave, you are going to go and... How's your fatigue looking like? Kind of high, too. God damn it. My people need some rest. These guys attacking at an ideal time. Infantry. And you're going to come over and just hang out over here. Meanwhile, we'll let him drop the stuff off. You guys need to hurry it up, though, because Silent Cycle can't be out there for too long by himself. Alright, so you hopefully dropped everything you needed to drop off. Remember, the game will pause by itself if I run into any trouble with Silent Cycle over there anyway. Or the moment she spots the goblin. Alright, so you shouldn't have anything in your inventory anymore. You don't. Excellent. You, however, are completely empty. Let's go and maintain your inventory, and we'll give you Light Helm. Light chest, shield, and sword, and light boots. Okay, so you get all that stuff, and then we'll have you give Silent Psycho a hand over here. Silent Psycho is actually kind of still far away, so it's not really big of a deal. Silent, if you don't mind, let me have you just kind of walk over here for now. And Goblin Man is over here. Goblin Man is actually chopping down fucking trees? Are you kidding me? This is actually pretty cool. He's over here chopping down trees. Do you guys try to build your own society too? That's actually pretty cool. If, like, you guys try to make your own village and then try to war against me later on. It's kind of terrifying, obviously, but it's kind of cool. So, Scabia, you ready to go? Come out here. Alright, so we're just going to basically do the whole two-pronged attack on this guy. That's what I want to do. Doesn't look like there's any more goblins around here. This guy's over here just chopping away. I'm surprised we honestly didn't lose some dragon. I was actually really worried for that individual. Alright, so you keep getting closer over here. Scabia is actually making her way over here too. Good. Good, good, good. So chicken over here on along its way. Along her way, I should say. Scabia, let's have you come down this way. And Fatal Extraction is over here, just hanging out. Now, Wood Chopping Man is over here. Remember, we don't want to get too close and trigger him just yet. But we do want to keep him in our sight. So you come over here. Run right into him. Just hang out over here if you can for a while. Scabia, you come in. Let's try to meet up over here if we can, actually. Alrighty. As long as I can keep an eye on him over here, like this way. You come over here. Alrighty, you guys are about to meet up? Perfect. This guy's over here just wandering around. What are you doing? Collecting some fucking wheat grass now, too? This guy, you know what? This is my map, dog. You want to collect some wheat and cut down trees, you got to go through me first. You got to, like, ask me for some permission. Maybe, I don't know, offer me some money. A little bit of a deal here. You just don't come over here and start, you know, running shit like you own a place. Alrighty. Scotland's going to get what's coming to him right now. I'm going to take that fireplace of yours, too, let me tell you. I'm going to kill you. I'm going to roast marshmallows and make s'mores in that fireplace right now. Alrighty. We spotted him. Charge the enemy. Scabby, I don't think I've given you a seek. Charge target enemies, that's good. And you should have the same thing, right, Silent? I mean, I don't see why you wouldn't. Yeah, okay, you're fine. Alrighty, so here we go. One, two, two attacks that it took. He did hit me one for one hit, and that was actually kind of bad. But we got him down. Everything's fine. Gather resources. Is there a way we could kind of get rid of this thing over here? Is that going to just handle itself over time? I wanted to make marshmallows in this thing. Make some nice s'mores and just to kind of celebrate our victory. But that's okay. Silent Psychopath, you could probably remove all the stuff from your inventory, assuming there's no more goblins around. I don't think there would be, but... There you go. And you are my carpenter? Is that what you were beforehand? I think you were. So let me just have you going back to carpenter work. Meanwhile, Silent Psychopath, carpenter, and then Scabia, you were building away. You were building, and let's have you remove all that stuff from your inventory. You don't need that anymore. But thank you for the being ready for the Call of Duty. No pun intended. All right, you guys go back. Sweet. Alrighty. And before we end this episode, let me pause the game one more time. Let's make sure that my area is secure over here. I just see a fire. I hope that'll go off by itself. I hope that's not, you know, calling other goblins over here. That would be pretty terrible. Excuse me, who is this over here? That's just my forager, and that is my... That's a dragon over here, cutting down trees. Alrighty! Oh, that was scary. But we got it under control. What a start of a recording day. I wasn't expecting to do it that way, but there you go. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Leave a thumbs up, leave a like. The support does mean a lot. I assure you, a lot more stuff is happening next episode. Unfortunately, I got stuck with this situation here, and I needed to deal with it. I will catch you next time.